really like skiing deep powder. I really like flying helicopters. That was the genesis of the...
Hey, hello everyone. Welcome back to the stream. I think my camera is not working. Give me a second, guys. I should be changing. Yeah, it's working only on that one USB port. So today I didn't use the camera on like that port. So I think that would be fixing that. Thanks guys. Thanks for coming and thanks for being part of this stream. So we are learning this IoT Edge solution. So we are building this Azure IoT Edge solution. So if anyone not sure what's the IoT Edge solution is. So Azure already have the Azure IoT Hub, so you can send all the data, you can send the messages from the device to the IoT Hub, so that like you are tracking all the messages. And recently, like Azure come up with this IoT Edge, that is basically a IoT Edge device. So you can add like more logic into your IoT Edge device, including detecting the machine learning algorithm, analytics, and the other stuff. So if you are doing that, then that would be like running on your device itself, right? For example, you are sending like a too much sensor data. So instead of sending every data to the IoT Hub cloud, you are just sending the data whatever you need for. For example, we are doing our temperature sensor, right? So the temperature sensor is going to keep on sending the data like every few seconds. But I'm not interested in like all those data. I'm just interested in the data, whichever it, whenever like it's going above threshold or the below threshold. So instead of like sending all the data to the IoT Hub and sending the alert there, everything is like low power devices, right? We are not like running on that the high compute or high power devices. We are running on like some small low power devices. So instead of sending all data, thinking about like the network and everything, this IoT Edge, this is a mini IoT Hub that's running on the device itself. So whenever the temperature sensor or like any sensor, it's sending the data, the module in the IoT Edge module is the custom code module, custom business module. You can write it on like any platform, including C#, JavaScript, Python, and Java. So the custom module or your custom business logic that's running on the device itself, and that's taking care of like, okay, I'm getting this data from the sensor, but I'm not really interested, so I'm not going to send that to the upstream, that means the IoT Hub. So it's doing those filter, or you can think about like any custom business logic apply to the data, whatever you are having in the device. So these custom modules will be doing those logic in the device itself, and it's sending to the upstream whenever it's required. So we initially discussed about like how we can create the IoT Edge solution and how we can add the modules in the IoT Edge solution. And there are like a different communication patterns that is available in the IoT Edge solution, including communicating between the modules and how to communicate between a module and the upstream, that means sending the data to the IoT Hub. And also there is another communication pattern, like communicating between the leaf device, that is a physical device. So those are the three things we have seen. Then we added the simulated temperature sensor module. It's already provided in the Microsoft, but in your like a we created on our own, which is the same thing, like it's going to generate the random number as a temperature sensor. So that one we have done, and we tried that Azure functions in IoT Edge solution, but Azure functions is like not supported in the JavaScript runtime right now. Only that C# module is supported in Azure IoT Edge runtime. So you can implement your custom C# functions in IoT Edge solution. They didn't have the JavaScript functions yet. I think hopefully it would be coming soon, based on whatever we have seen on their GitHub or their milestone. So those things we have seen. One second, I will open the dashboard. So those things we have seen, and we are trying to build the boat watch application. So this is a concept I'm trying to simulate it, so that we are putting a full-fledged IoT solution, like the production based ready, and discussing about like how we can bring the different modules into this project and all. So I am trying to build a solution reference or reference architecture stuff in in this GitHub repository. So if you go and see the boat watch, boat classification. So in this repository, I'm trying to put like how the Azure IoT Edge solution looks like, and how we are going to look like the sensor data, stream analytics, Azure functions, those stuff, and how the deployment can be done, and how the provision is done. So we are going to analyze like the real-time production stuff one by one, and going through the documents from the Azure Doc or the Microsoft Visual Studio Docs. We are trying to go through that one by one. So that's our plan. So let's start the code. It's in my personal directory. What's that boat classification and IoT Edge solution? So I'm opening that in the code base. Yesterday what we did see is like we are trying to run everything from the Docker container, but there are like options. You can run your IoT Edge modules from the local itself. That means your laptop is going to be a physical device for that. So today let's clean up those things, how to run the IoT Edge solution module from the local. Because if you think of that, the development, the day-to-day development activity, right? I can run that in the Docker, but every time Docker is like building all the modules. For example, here we have the three modules here: temperature sensor, filter sensor data, and the dashboard. So if you go to the deployment.template.json, you are having different modules apart from the system module. So system module is like Edge Agent and Edge Hub. This is provided by the Microsoft Azure IoT Edge itself. So these modules is taking care of communicating between the modules and sending that to that IoT Hub, those kind of things. And we can add like the custom modules also here, right? So in the custom module, we have added this temperature sensor, dashboard, and the filter sensor data. So these are the three modules we are trying to use. So you can see like these three modules, the deployment is based on the Docker only. So if I am running this application from the Visual Studio Code itself, I need to build and run IoT Edge solution in simulator. So when I put like a build and run IoT Edge solution in simulator, it's going to build all the Docker containers for the modules and creating the network between the Docker containers, and it's running like all the containers at a time. Then the the Edge Hub and the Edge device container, it's taking care of like communicating between the containers, between these modules using the network. So that's the overall overall behavior, how it looks like. But what I'm thinking is like if you see the Visual Studio Code file that's generated, it has like two components. One is a remote debug. So this remote debug is to debug the application that is running on the Docker container. So in our case, it's running on this AMD64 simulator. So if I run that build and run IoT solution in simulator, it's going to run the Docker containers, and this remote debug is like trying to access the debug port that is exposed by the Docker file. What I mean is, if we go to the filter sensor data, there is a two different Docker file, and also like there is another architecture file. So there are like four Docker files here, right? So in these four Docker file, there are like AMD64 and ARM32v7s. If you go and deploy this code in the Raspberry Pi or any the low power devices, that's based on the ARM32v7 architecture, right? And we are running on the AMD64. You can see like the AMD64 stuff. So there is in the AMD64 also, there is like two flavors of the Docker file here. One is AMD64. This is how it runs in the production. And there is AMD64 debug. what it's doing is it's exposing the port. For example, here it's just like a running node inspect, and it's exposed the port to debug, right? So let's go back to the VS Code launch.json. So there are like a two thing, right? So if you do that, the remote debug, it's opening the port. For example, here the temperature sensor, sorry, what we are looking for, the filter sensor data. So if you see, the port is 9230. That 9230 is exposed here. So once I start running the Docker container, and if I do, if I open the debug thing and try to debug like a filter sensor data remote debug, this is going to debug the code, whatever that's running in the Docker container, right? But what I am trying to do is, instead of like running the code every time in the Docker container, it's taking like too much time, because sometimes it needs to do that npm package stuff for the production thing. So I don't want to do that. I just want to run all these Docker IoTH modules from the IoTH modules from the local machine itself, right? So that's what I'm trying to do. So if you see here, to run from the local, we need the Edge Hub connection string and the CA certificate file. So this is pulling from the Visual Studio config. Since I have configured these IoT Hub devices in the Visual Studio code, I messed up something. So if I am opening the user settings here and going to the extensions and Azure IoT Edge configuration, it should be in the settings.json somewhere. So you can see like my connection string is here. So it's already set in that Visual Studio itself, because we connected our IoT Hub from the Visual Studio code. So that's already in the Visual Studio code configuration, the user settings. So when I am trying to run that in the local, it's directly running the program. For example, the filter sensor data, it's running the modules filter sensor data on the app.js, and the environment variable is Edge Hub connection string that is coming from the Visual Studio code, and the CA certificate file that also coming from the Visual Studio code. So what I am going to do is let me run the temperature sensor and the filter sensor data alone in the local. So temperature sensor, so that I can do like a quick fast development in the local machine itself, and before going into the production, I just like deploy that in the production thing. Okay, it says cannot find module Azure IoT device MQTT. I have that module, right? It's okay. I need to do the npm install. So go to the modules, temperature sensor, and npm install. Since I'm running in the Docker container, this npm install is happening only in the Docker container. It's not done in the local. So right now I'm trying to run that in the local. So I'm setting up my temperature sensor module like this. Now if I am running this in the local, I got few more error. Okay, so these things I am trying to fix. Reference error, environment variable IoT Edge workload URI was not provided from the environment edge. From environment, it should be having this environment edge connection, edge hub connection string, and the edge module CA certificate file. So if you see here, it should be getting from this, but I don't know why this one is not showing here. Azure IoT edge hub connection string. Do we need to set that connection string? For example, Azure IoT Edge connection string or something. Set module credentials to user settings. What's that? Okay, it's setting my secrets. Oh, there is a set module credentials to user setting. So once I set the credentials, it should be setting that to the this configuration, I believe. Now let me check my user settings here. Azure IoT Edge. Yeah, I have this connection string. I think I would better open the file. Application extension Azure IoT Edit. Okay, now I have the configuration IoT Edge hub connection string, and as well as my CA certificate file. So once I have both of the stuff, it should be injected in here. Now I try to do the local debug. Yeah, now it's connected and attached. So here, if I put the breakpoint, every 5 seconds it's going to send the data to it's going to send the output even from the IoT module client. Is it sending or any error? Okay, let me restart here. Okay, if I run the module, where it should be connecting, right? So still this is I'm not sure how to open this thing. Okay, let me go and check their documentation. So if anyone trying to understand like what I'm doing, we are building the IoT Edge solution. So till yesterday we just like are running the IoT Edge modules in the Docker container, but that's taking like too much time on every build. So I'm trying to look that in the local how to run that in the local machine itself. So let's going back to the documentation here. Overview Azure IoT Edge. Okay, so these are the things we are trying to look at. So how to guides register an IoT device, this one we have done. View devices, copy connection string, this stuff, and install and manage IoT Edge, develop and debug modules in VS Code. Okay, so we have this VS Code and we have the IoT tool, Docker extension, everything, and we created the new IoT Edge solution. We are developing the module. Okay, so here it is, debug a module without a container. So if you are developing C#, Node.js, Java, your module requires use of module client object in the default module code so that it can start, run and route messages. You will also use the default input channel. Yeah, so setting up the IoT Edge simulator for IoT Edge solution. In device explorer on the left side, right click on your IoT Edge device ID, set up IoT Edge simulator to start the simulator with a connection string. Okay, so this is what we are trying to do. So first I need to run the IoT Edge simulator. I think I already have this one, but anyhow, I will follow the document here. So here, set up IoT Edge simulator. So it's trying to set up the IoT Edge simulator here. It's asking. Okay, it's set up successfully. Now I can directly click the temperature sensor data here. Okay, so here it's error, but it's not opening the connect to the edge instance. So this is what I'm trying to look at, like oh, the Docker is not running. Oh, maybe that's the reason. The Docker is not running. Okay, now the Docker desktop is starting. The Docker is not running, so maybe that's the reason. So we are trying to run the IoT Edge module locally. So if you generate that project from the Visual Studio Code, you are having both settings, including local debug, so that you are running your IoT Edge module locally. Still, it needs to connect to the Edge Hub instance, but that is pulling your connection string and the CA certificate file to connect to the data. That's pulling that one from your Visual Studio Code settings itself. So once you have configured this IoT Hub devices in your VS Code, then it should be set in your Visual Studio Code user settings. So it's setting up the environment and it's trying to run the module locally. Right now we are testing that one, but the Docker didn't run. Maybe that's why it's not connecting to the Edge Hub instance. So if I go to the Docker container here, refreshing that, I'm having this stuff and I'm having this Azure IoT Edge Hub container, and also what are the other containers I'm having? There are like a couple of containers stopped. I think it should be taking care of debugging the local module. So let me run this again. So it's creating the client from environment variable. I think the client is getting generated. Now we need to see whether client is able to connect to the edge instance. That's what not happening right now. So that's why I'm just looking like why that's not happening. So it's coming up to here, but the client open, it's not working, it seems. Or let's give like a few seconds whether it's coming with the timeout error or something like that. The documentation says debug module. Okay, so here it is, right? So debug module without a container. So we set up the IoT Edge simulator for our IoT Edge solution. Yeah, this what we have done, right? Let me do it again. So going back to the devices, set up IoT Edge Simulator. So it's setting up my IoT Edge Simulator, including the connection string. It says IoT Edge Simulator successfully. That should be somewhere here. That's the IoT Edge Hub device. So it's already there. It says like authenticated locally also, but why it's not connecting? Okay, do we need to stop this thing? I'm stopping like the existing Docker containers. Oh, I think it's still connecting to the Docker container only. It's not connecting to the local stuff. Okay, let's watch for this log. Let me run the temperature sensor local again. So client from environment, we got the client, but the client open, it's not making to this callback. So once the client is connected to the Edge instance, then only we can send the output event, or we can receive the input event, right? I don't know why this is not happening. Let's go back to our logs here. Where it is? Is it in the terminal here? Yeah. So IoT Edge Hub, still it says dashboard is not connected. The Edge Hub device IoT. Okay, so the Edge Hub container is the core of the local IoT Edge Simulator. Yes, it can run on your development machine without the IoT Edge security daemon, and provides the environment settings for your native module app or module containers. Okay, so prepare your environment for debugging according to the requirements of your development language. Set a breakpoint. So this one is for C#, and Node.js, we did the npm install and we tried to debug the local debugger Node.js from the dropdown also. This one is for the remote debug. Oh, I don't know, it's not working for me here. So going back to the Docker, probably I would stop this container also. Oh, where's the IoT? Yeah, Edge Hub device, right? Okay, let me remove this container. And going back to the devices, setting up IoT Edge Simulator. So it set up my IoT Edge Simulator successfully. That means it should be setting the container as well. Is it right? Oh, it's not. So something. Okay, let's go back to the documentation again. Okay. In the device explorer, yeah, this is what I have done to start the simulator with the device connection string. You can see IoT Edge Simulator has been successfully set up. That's right. And I am not setting up the simulator for single module app. I am setting that for like the entire module, right? Okay. Oh, now, yeah, see, after timeout, I'm getting the error here. It says connection refused 883. So that means like my edge hub thing, it's not running, right? That's what it's saying. Okay, let's see what are the other option here. So run IoT Edge solution in simulator. I don't want, because this one is running like in the Docker container. And I set up the IoT Edge simulator. It says like set up successfully. Show sample gallery IoT Edge module, not this thing. Edge hub container. Okay, so Docker images, Docker containers. I don't have any container running right now. Okay, let me open this Edge agent. So somehow I need to connect this. So that's what the simulator should be doing. So it should be set up the IoT Edge simulator. So I'm missing something in the documentation here. IoT Edge Hub Device CLI. Let me start that as well. So I'm starting that one using the command line. Okay, so the IoT Edge Hub simulator has been started in single module mode and send message through this one. Okay, what does that mean? Okay, so if I try temperature sensor local right now, it should be connecting. Hey, yeah, it's connected here. Great. So the IoT Hub module client initialized and it's sending the data like every 5 seconds. Great. Yeah, this one is working. Now can I run the same another module into that IoT Edge stuff, because it says like it's running the IoT Edge IoT Edge Hub device simulator for single module, right? But I want to test like multiple modules at the same time. So let's see like the filter sensor data here. So I'm running that one. Oh, I might need to install the npm install stuff. So going to the modules, filter sensor data, npm install. Okay, it's installed. Now if I run filter sensor data local, let me go and okay, it came here, right? Filter sensor data. Yeah, I put a breakpoint here as well as here. So if I'm running that, oh, this also connected to the IoT. Then why it says like the IoT Edge Hub device for single module? I thought like a single module, only one module can connect to that the simulator. Okay, I think we need to start like IoT Edge Hub device start, whatever you have typed here. Now we need to see. How it's receiving the data, right? Maybe that part is missing because okay, let's see that. Where is our temperature sensor? And this is not the temperature sensor. How to move this one? So the temperature sensor here, putting the breakpoint here. Okay, it's having the data and it's sending to the output event. So the output event, it should be hitting here, but it's not. Because we didn't set up this the router messages, right? Yeah, so how to set up these routes? Okay, let me stop this one and the temperature sensor also. Now let's see. What are the options available here? So help. Start. Okay, so here it is. Now I need to give the deployment. Deployment using the deployment manifest. So start IoT Edge Hub simulator. Okay, this is what happening right now. But I want for like the whole solution mode. So the deployment file would be deployment.template.json. Okay, I think this piece is missing from the document, or I might be overreading the documentation. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to start this IoT Edge Hub device runtime so that I can debug all the modules from locally. The document says set up the IoT Edge simulator for IoT Edge solution. So this is what I have done, but it's not connected. Still, it throws the error. But if I'm trying IoT Edge Hub device start, then it should be working. Okay. So JSON object must be string, bytes or byte array, not dictionary. What does that mean? I don't want the single module mode. I want the solution mode. And I provided the deployment template JSON as well. Okay, let me run IoT Edge solution in simulator. Config deployment.amdc. Okay, I think I should be starting like this. Let me. Okay, I'm running IoT Edge Hub device dot minus D, but it's creating all the modules. So this one I don't want. Because you can see like it's still running from the container. Okay, let it be. So now if I am trying to run the local stuff, so first I will run the temperature sensor. It's attached and it opened also. Then I am opening the filter sensor data. This also should be attaching to the filter sensor data, and this also should be opening, but I'm looking for like the message that's receiving here. So the temperature sensor data, it's sending output event temperature every 5 seconds. It should be receiving in the filter sensor data, because we have provided that one, the route here, temperature sensor to filter sensor data from all the outputs to the input here. Yeah, it should be coming here, but it's not coming. So that's where that I'm struggling here. Let's see the troubleshoot guide. Develop and debug modules. Okay, so debug module in launch mode, Node.js. This is what the local debug is looks like. I'm trying to debug both the modules in the IoT Edge runtime. It seems like both are connecting to the IoT Edge runtime simulator, but the route we are using, this one is working whenever we are running this in the Docker container, but it's not working whenever I'm running this in the local. So I'm just looking the documentation, like how to fix this stuff. Add a breakpoint, create options. So these are the things. Debug a module with IoTH runtime. Use any of the files that end with the extension .debug to build your module for testing. Set up your IoTH device, build your IoTH modules. This one we have done. But this one is debugging in that emulator, right? Okay. I think at least we can test from the single module instead of like testing the whole stuff. Okay, I think we are at least we are partially successful on running the local IoTH module in the Visual Studio Code. Okay, so let me quickly run this one in the simulator. I think it's already running. So if I am going to localhost 3001, this is going to be the dashboard application. So you can see like the temperature sensor data that's sending the data, and it's immediately reflecting in the dashboard. So now today what we are going to do is we are going to add like a few more modules. So let's go back to our code here. So instead of the temperature sensor, I'm just thinking to rename the module here so that like it's containing like all the device sensor module instead of the temperature sensor. Did you get like what I'm saying? Because if we add like each individual sensor module, that would be fine, but it's not like necessarily needed for our solution. We are trying to achieve like how everything looks together. But if it's really needed, then probably at the time we can just like start another module. So let me add Azure IoT Edge, add IoT Edge module, deployment template.json, existing module from ECR. No, not that one. Existing module. Okay, so what is that? Microsoft simulated temperature sensor. Okay, later this one as it is. So now what we are trying to do is we need to generate the random number smoothly. Gradually or smoothly. Okay, so algorithm for smooth random numbers. for example, instead of wind speed random 100, so this is what we are trying to achieve. So wind speed equal to wind speed minus 4 plus random of 9. What does that mean? So wind speed greater than 90. Okay, so minus 4 plus 0 to 8 gives minus 4 to 4. Okay. So simply just pick random numbers within the certain range and build on the change gradually every seconds until they reach random change over a time. Okay. What is the Benford's law? Smooth random numbers. So start somewhere between 0 and 99, and for 1000 or plus random dot range of minus 3 comma 4. Okay. Yeah. In our case, let's go back to the temperature sensor. So we are generating the random interval from min to max, that is 0 to 80 for us. So that is this one, right? So okay, so let's start with this one here. So const temperature, not the const one, where temperature equal to random interval from 0 to 80. So we have that one. Then every time we are going to add temperature plus how to do that? Smooth random. I want like I want something like this to show the graph. Smooth graph. Okay, smooth random.js they already have. And what's that doing? It's setting up the factor, smoothing factor. Okay, so factor and start. So here they are sending a factor and start. So they have the samples as well. So for 100 samples, they are pushing the data here. Okay, that seems cool. So in our case, this is the random value, right? So let me try with this one. So I'm having this smooth random function. Then that smooth random function, I'm calling it here. That is something like this. Get temperature smooth random of factor, let's say like 1, and start. Let me try with the 10 here, and every time I need to call the get temperature, that should be returning the number. Is it right? I'm not sure. So let's put the console.log here to see like how this one is looks like. So for this one, let's try that locally. Temperature sensor local debug node.js. Running it in the debugger. So it's running the client and also it's sending the data to here. Okay, I think I need to run the IoTH runtime. So IoTH simulator, run IoTH solution in simulator, not that one. Single module, right? Start IoTH hub simulator for single module. Start IoTH. Or I can just like simply say IoT H hub start device start. So this would be running the IoT H hub device runtime, and then I can run that one from locally. I am trying to create like a smooth random number for the sensor data. Anyhow, like we are trying to generate the temperature sensor data, so that's what we are trying to do. So let me run that IoTH module locally. It's creating this client, and the client is opened. So from here we are getting a get temperature function, and every 5 seconds we are sending the data. So if I put the breakpoint here, so we'll wait for 5 seconds. Okay, so now the data temperature has 6.175. what's the next time? 3.14. I just want to make sure like this is smoothly instead of like hitting too much thing. Okay, I think it's pretty smooth, but I want like the big number of data. So what we will be doing is so factor and start, right? The start one I put like 10, so it's keep on like reducing the, it's smoothing and it's reducing the level. Okay, I think once it is reached the zero, it should be picking it up again. Yeah, now it's 10, 35. Oh. Okay, so something going on there. I want like the smooth transition on the number. So return the number within half range here. Okay, the usage is smooth random of 2. In our case, okay, so here it is. Value 5, min max 1 to 20. Okay. So min max 1 to 20. What does that mean? So this dot, okay, let me do instead of this one, I just put like 5 here, and run this one again. I think I got this one. So instead of this math.random, I think we need to put our random interval from this one. So that's why like it's just like a change between the last and max. Yeah. So 0.43, 0.51, it should be climbing up gradually, because it's just like generating the random number between 0 to 1. That's what happening here, right? So what we will do is we just put like a random int interval from min and max here, that is 0 to 80. That's what we are trying to have for the temperature sensor read. Now if I am running this one, get temperature. Okay, the temperature is 12 here. I don't want this one work like this. Let me stop this one. Let's go to our simulated temperature sensor module, IoT hub. They say like the code is here, but I didn't see the code. The source code is not currently open source. Yeah. Okay. It's not open source right now. They have removed this code or something like that. Yeah, they have removed the code. Okay, smooth. Let's keep on Google that. Smooth random number. Random walk here. So box Mueller transform to generate Gaussian random walk. These things I have learned in my mathematics class, but it's very I want to understand these logics. Why this is so hard here? Okay, so on the JS Fiddle, someone already have this one. Yeah, I want like this kind of data. So the box Mueller random generate plots. How many, probably like It's generating like 10 plot. I just like put one. So if I run here, yeah, I want something like this. So it's generating the plot, it's generating random walk. So the random walk is here. And the steps random function, it's generating through the Boxmuller function. So it's checking for like how many steps. And it's generating the plots here. So for our case, it's generating the plot get y values of random walk. But where they are providing, like it should be generating between 0 to minus 25 or something like that, right? Get y value, get generate plots here. Plot of index, y charts, random walk. Okay, so here it is, x minus 20 and x minus 20. So get y values here. Okay, it's having 100 steps and using the Boxmuller random. And every step it's calling the random function and pushing the value here. So this is what like we should be doing. I think I'm pretty much done with today. So I will take a look at like those Boxmuller random number, so that it would be sending the random generated data. Otherwise, probably I would be implementing that with a real device, so that it's reading the sensor data from the actual device. So once that is done, then probably we'll be doing. So today we spend most of the time on setting up the local development instead of doing the Docker container. So I think we have achieved a good amount of thing there. So let's see, probably like we will see on Saturday's stuff. We will try to integrate the remaining sensors and we will complete the dashboard. Then probably we will be including the analytics IoTH module and the other stuff. I think I am pretty good today. So if anyone trying to get a chance to see this video later, please come stop by and we will learn this IoT Edge solution together. I am doing the streaming on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, 8 PM EST. Sometime it's like a short stream, sometime I would stream for like more than 2 hours. And the next stream would be on Saturday, and Saturday morning 9. I think I scheduled for Saturday noon, but I thinking of like moving to Saturday morning 9. So I'll be doing those stuff. So come and say hi if you get a chance. Till then, see you guys. See you next time. Bye.